For example, we have a diagram given, which is time versus velocity. 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 15 seconds, 20 seconds, 25 and 30 seconds. This is, let's say, 4 meters per second, and this is 8 meters per second. Now the question is, velocity versus time diagram is represented like this. So first 5 seconds, velocity is increasing from 0 to 8 meters per second. Then for next, let's say 15 seconds, which is 15 seconds. So we were discussing about this problem. So I once again repeat, we have a velocity versus time representation of a particle. It shows that this is time and this is velocity axis. Now it is starting at t is equal to 0, velocity is 0. First 5 seconds, velocity is increasing from 0 to 8 meter per second. Then for 15 seconds, velocity remains constant. And then for next 10 seconds, velocity is reducing to 0. So this is the question we have. Now we need to find total displacement. How do we do that? So the answer is simple. Whenever we represent, take a simple case of, let's say, time versus velocity, and for simplicity, velocity remains constant. So how do we say that distance or displacement equals velocity into time? So let's say velocity is v and time taken is t, so it's v into t. Now v into t is nothing but area of the graph between point 1 to 2. So v into t, this is v on the x-axis, y-axis, and time. So v into t is area of this, which is equal to area of the rectangle, let's say 1, 2, 3. So area of the rectangle 0, 1, 2, 3. Now using the same analogy, we will be able to find the total displacement by calculating area of the shaded region, which is under the graph, let's say 0, 1, 2, 3. So whatever area covered under 0, 1, 2, 3 is the total displacement. So let's say we name it 4, 5. So total displacement equals area O15 plus area 514 415 plus area 523. So this is a triangle, this is a rectangle, again this is a triangle. So half, height is equal to 8, base is equal to 5. So half into 8 into 5 plus, this is 15, this is 8. So 15 into 8 plus, again 8 into, this distance is 10. So 1 by 2 into 8 into 10, which is equal to 5, 4. So 25 plus 120 plus 40, which is equal to 185 meters. So this is the final displacement. If somebody asks in the same problem definition, what is the acceleration between first 5 seconds? Acceleration between first 5 seconds. So as per our definition, acceleration is equal to V final minus V initial by time taken. So V final is equal to 8, initial time is 0, initial velocity is 0, time taken is 5 seconds, so it's 8 by 5 meter per second. What is the acceleration between 1 to 2? There is no change in velocity, so acceleration is 0. What is happening between 2 to 3? It's a case of negative acceleration, which we could call retardation. And again, acceleration is minus final velocity minus initial velocity by time taken. Final velocity is 0, initial velocity is 8, time taken is equal to 10. So it's like minus 8 by 10, that is equal to 0.8 meter per second square. So that's the way we could solve any problem which is defining motion with the help of graph. Please remember that on a velocity versus time graph, area under the velocity plot gives you the total displacement. To calculate acceleration or retardation, just calculate the final velocity minus initial velocity and time taken. One thing needs to be taken care is, we need to watch the velocity variation with time. We cannot combine initial to final and then we can calculate acceleration, because this part shows that it's a object is accelerating, this part it is acceleration is 0, this part retarding. So these three components need to be separated out to calculate the acceleration or retardation happening in that zone. Okay, let's take one more problem. We have a long tower of height, let's say h. Question is, a object is dropped from top of the tower and which goes like this. It says that in the last second, that is the, this is the 1 second duration, which is the 1 second before it hits the ground, and the distance traveled is Sn, and it is given that it covers 35 meter. So the question is, a body is dropped from this point. So I write the question. A body is fall from top of a tower and covers 35 meter in the last second of its fall. Question is, find the height of the tower. So now we have a formula which says, Sn is equal to u plus 2n minus 1 by 2 into g. G is positive because object is falling downward. Using the value, Sn is given as 35, initial velocity we are saying 0, started from 0, so 2n minus 1 by 2 into 10. So after simplification, 2, 5. So we get 2n minus 1 into 5 is equal to 35. Now 5, 7. So therefore 2n is equal to 7 plus 1. Therefore n is equal to 8 by 2, that is 4 seconds. Therefore n is equal to 4 seconds. That means what it says is that it takes 4 seconds for the object to come from top of the tower to the ground. Initial velocity is given. So can we calculate distance traveled? So the distance traveled total is x is equal to ut plus half at square. U is known to us 0, so u into t is 0. Half a is 10. Total time taken is equal to 4 seconds. So 4 square 2, okay, that is equal to, let's write 2 1, okay, 5. So 4 into 4 16, 5 into 16, so 16 into 5, 80 meter. So height of the tower is 80 meter. So we can again explain it saying that if a tower has a height of 80 meter, so h is equal to 80 meter. If an object is dropped from top of this tower with initial velocity 0, it takes 4 seconds to reach the ground. In the last second, it travels 35 meter per second.